decision to exercise, more is easy. Unfortunately, it's just as easy to hit snooze on your alarm clock in the morning. You can have the best intentions for your new workout plan and still not stick to it. So how do you meet your workout goals? Lisa Kuzman is a life coach and is here to share some tips for how to meet those workout goals. Thanks so much for joining us today.
Thank you for having me.
So this is a topic I'm sure many people deal with. Why is it so easy to have that mindset? I mean, we talk about how good working out is for us. We always feel great after a workout and happy we did it. But why do we have that mindset that it's so hard to actually get ourselves to do it?
I think sometimes we're just so exhausted and we're so tired. So it makes it really challenging to have that motivation to stick with the goal that we set out in the beginning.
So working out sometimes can feel like a chore. So how do we make our workout fun so that it doesn't feel like that?
I love having an accountability buddy or someone who you know that you enjoy, or having a routine that feels like fun instead of sort of a laborious or confusing process. I often end up, at least for myself and for some of my clients, I'll be at the gym and then I'm tired or I have a lot going on in my mind, so to sequence all the things that I need to do, say, to make sure that I lift in the way that I want to lift or I get cardio in that I want to get, I don't want to think through those things. So if I have a class or a workout buddy or something that I already know is going to be really enjoyable, that helps for me.
So what do we need to do first to set ourselves up for success? What's the first process for all of this?
I think having a good plan is number one. So that plan can include a lot of different things, like making sure that your breakfast is ready, your clothes are set out, you know what you want to do when you want to do it so that you actually get the workout in and like as you're going through your already really busy schedule.
And so you said to plan. So would you recommend actually taking the time to map out, write out what workout you're going to do, maybe even the night before?
I think so. I think the night before, and I also think having more of a long game type plan is really important. So when you look at, like, if you set a goal, maybe wanting to run a half marathon, and that's going to be so many weeks or months away, you know that you have to hit certain goals along the way so that you have the physical ability to hit that big goal. And yet, then there's the weekly and daily things that you have to do that is the actionable thing that helps you get where you're going.
So staying flexible. This can seem a little bit difficult just because if you are such a planner and you aren't sticking to your normal routine, mm-hmm. you know, then you just don't do it sometimes. Mm-hmm. So when you say stay flexible, how can you get yourself to get used to that?
I think that what I think about when I think about flexibility is we can be really mean to ourselves and we can beat ourselves up in our head thinking, gosh, I missed that workout. I really wish that, what's the point, right? What's the point to continue on? Maybe you can rearrange something later in your day and still get your workout in. Maybe adapt the workout to less time if you have to be flexible to get it figured out, or rearrange the way that you might spend your time throughout the rest of the week. So when I think about flexibility, I think a little bit about mindset flexibility and then getting creative to still hit your goal with your workouts.
And now one of those points was having a backup plan. So what is an example of a backup plan?
I think that a backup plan so when you have, like, I'm going to work out Monday, Wednesday, Friday, right? But you know that Friday might be a little harder for you, or you're really tired on Wednesdays, the backup plan would be like, well, if I don't get to the gym on Wednesday morning, I'll be able to do it Thursday afternoon. But you typically don't work out on Thursdays, you work out Monday, Wednesday, Friday. So a backup plan would be a way to have an alternate option if you know that your schedule might get overwhelming or something unexpected might come up, so that you kind of have that plan in place so you don't have to create it in the midst of the busy schedule.
So everyone has their own routine or their own time that they like to work out. Mm-hmm. But for those people who like to work out in the morning and get it done before they go to work and do their other tasks for the day, what are some tips? Because it is so easy to hit that snooze button.
Yeah. My favorite tip is, there's a couple. First is to put your workout clothes out so that you don't have to go find your shoes and your socks and whatever it is that you need for your workout. It's already prepared and ready. And then I also really like to, when you hit the snooze button, you can kind of forget why you want to go to the gym or why it is that it feels good because you're so tired and you just want to rest. So I will encourage my clients and even for myself to think about, well, how is it that I'll feel when I'm done with the workout? And it's always like, oh, that'll be so wonderful and it'll totally feel worth it. And so I'm a little more motivated to actually roll out of bed.
And how can we track our goals? I know a lot of people can get discouraged if they're not seeing this number on the scale change, but what are some ways to track your goals or keep track of what workouts you're doing?
Yeah, I think that you can do it however works for you. Some people are paper planners, some people are online planners, meaning online schedule like your Google Calendar. I think that however it works best for you to acknowledge that you did it. So in the past, I got a little package of gold stars and I would put a gold star on my paper calendar so that I gave myself credit for the workout. I eventually just started like drawing a star. So there's a lot of different ways that you can actually put it on your calendar. And so that you, A, get the credit, and you remind yourself that you've done it. So, and it allows for you to plan around it, too. So if it's actually on your calendar and you've scheduled it in, then it's easier to get it done.
So we've went through the planning, the preparation, the tracking, getting your workout done, but a lot of people can be discouraged if they're not seeing results. So what is one piece of advice you have for people who, you know, maybe have given it 2-3 weeks and now they're ready to give up because they don't feel anything has changed?
Right. It takes so long to create change and to feel that in our bodies and in our minds. Overall wellness, there's so many incredible benefits for wellness. It helps us be healthier, it helps our minds, it helps our mood, it helps our relationships, and it takes a while to actualize the change that happens when you move. And so I think that just being patient with yourself, being forgiving with yourself, and sticking with it is really important.
Lots of great information. Thank you so much, Lisa.
Yeah, thank you.